Today, we are running Windows 10 on things you should not run Windows 10 on, including old systems, phones, Macs, iPads. So cast your mind wide open to the most obscure, bizarre thing you could possibly imagine running Windows, and we're gonna do it today. Why did I just jump on the desk? I'm not sure, but it felt right.
Microsoft just released Windows 365, which allows you to run your own dedicated Windows 10 PC in the cloud on literally anything that has a web browser. So let's put that to the test. I started out by signing up for the higher tier at a pretty expensive $66 a month, which comes with 4 CPU cores, 16 gigs of RAM, and 128 gigs of storage. Although realistically, you can get up and running for close to $20 a month for a lower spec machine. To start out with, the first device that I would love to run Windows 10 on is the iPad.
For the best results, Microsoft recommends using the Remote Desktop Client. Now, this is something that you can use with your own PC, right? If you have, I believe, Windows 10 Pro, pretty much any PC can log in and you can use it on a Mac or whatever. But what we can use it for is accessing our Windows 365 app in the cloud. So the advantage to using the Remote Desktop Client, first of all, as you can see, it's actually properly scaled. You also have pretty much full support for everything on the iPad. So I can use the touchscreen on Windows, right? The cursor is pretty damn smooth. The camera works? What? Are you kidding me? Wait, you guys see this. I mean, there's mad latency, of course. Okay. Sorry, I was not expecting that. So I think we're gonna try a bunch of devices, but the gist of it, I think, is if you have a regular desktop web browser, it will work fairly well, but if you can get access to the Remote Desktop app, you're gonna have a much better experience accessing your Windows 365 device. So I have installed the Remote Desktop app on my Z Flip. So let's just see what happens when I launch it. Configuring and, oh my God, it works! Not only does it work, it just changed over to the Z Flip's aspect ratio. Oh wow! Yo, whoa. Wait, this is actually not terrible. Anywhere you place on the screen, it just moves the cursor. It just doesn't stop! No matter what device I throw at it, it's just like, yeah, sure, no problem. Oh my God! This is so dumb. But look at my Windows Z Flip, boys! Come on! This is a video which is pure fun, pure delight, pure entertainment. What can we try next? So we've got a Core i7, I believe that's a first or second gen Core i7, 4 gigs of RAM, HD 3000 graphics. I mean, this is not anything all that impressive. Now, I've specifically picked this because it is too old to use at least the version on the App Store that we would normally use of the Remote Desktop software. So I'm gonna try to just load up in Safari, windows365.com, and see if it works. Now, I'm gonna do this on Wi-Fi. This MacBook does have Ethernet. That would probably slightly improve our performance, but I want to try to keep it somewhat realistic. All right, let's see what kind of speeds that the Microsoft server has on the other end.
And our server is in Washington.
It
that
is.
That makes sense.
All right, ready and...
You could stream off that.
Yeah, you think. Wait, let's see the upload. Come on, hit me. Hit me. We got that big, oh, hey, oh.
Oh,
it's,
oh, keep, wow.
It's going. Let's fucking go, boys. Yo, 1400 megabits, 1.4 gigabits down and 2.7 gigabits up. I can use that crazy fast upload to dump files to it and pull it down on my local device, right? Obviously, to get something on this device itself, I need a good internet connection. But if I'm saving stuff to the cloud, I've got almost 3 gigabits upload. Woo! This actually works really well. Again, this is an old version of Safari. We're several generations behind. And I would say the performance and the actual, like, look, I've got 2 fingers scrolling here. Look how, like, that's maybe a third of a second latency. I figured that the Remote Desktop app on something like the iPad or even on the Z Flip would be the best scenario. But I mean, that's super smooth. What's that? Why'd you bring a Chromebook? If it works on an old 2011 MacBook with an out-of-date version of Safari, it's gonna work on a Chromebook.
We can make it a real computer.
Chrome OS is a real thing.
No, it's not.
It is absolutely a thing.
Stop tricking our audience into thinking that these things are useful.
So, I have got this old ThinkPad, which is legitimately been sitting around for, 3 years. This is a Core 2 Duo system. And I got it because I originally wanted to do a video because this was one of the oldest systems that I could buy that would support Windows 10. So for context, this is a system with a Core 2 Duo T9400. We've got ourselves 4 gigs of RAM, and we've got ourselves a 112 gig, I think it's a hard drive actually. I don't even think there's an SSD in here. Should we just fire up an Edge and see what happens? Now, I will say that this has got the old version of Edge because I have not touched the system in like several years. So non-Chromium Edge. But hey, we're gonna try old stuff. Let's try old stuff, shall we? Activate, and look at that. We're back in there. I will say the quality looks significantly worse. Like, you can just see it's kind of blurry. Okay, that's a lot worse. So maybe we're hitting the limits for what this Core 2 Duo can handle. So that's about the smallest window we can get. Is this gonna work better? Oh, it is actually.
Yeah, because it's a lesser resolution video, right? So.
Interesting. Okay, so you can get this usable even on, I would say, ridiculously outdated hardware. I think we've pretty well established that the Windows 365 and the remote desktop, it's pretty good. It works on a lot of devices, but I don't think we can just go old with it. I don't think we can just go outdated with it. I think we should take a little look over. It's truly the most budget, bargain basement, low-end hardware we can. No, not the RTX 3090. This, the Raspberry Pi Zero. This is a computer that costs, what, $5-$10? Single core, literally the lowest spec possible. It qualifies as a computer, but not by much.
I mean, this is a project kind of system, not really for anything else, but I'd be impressed if it can at least run it. To be fair, Matt and I put bets on how long it'll take for you to load this, and we both bet against you.
I don't think it's gonna work. I think it will not be usable. I think that's my problem.
I'm gonna leave the camera there because I'm tired of holding it.
It's just gonna be a montage now of Austin waiting for a Raspberry Pi Zero to load a web page for the next 15 minutes.
Yes.
So, all right, we've already given up. We're just switching to the 400.
Okay.
Look at that. Look how much better this is. Oh my gosh. Okay, so immediately we'll say it feels pretty blurry. So let's full screen it.
Image compression. It's hard to get that on camera, but it's not particularly good.
It definitely looks like I'm watching a 720p video of a Windows system.
But to be fair, we are also looking at this on like a 48-inch TV.
Yeah. There might be a scenario in which if you have some kind of native remote desktop app, it runs better. But even on what is a relatively powerful Raspberry Pi, at least in Pi terms, the 400, this is not a good experience, at least running in the browser. It's so laggy. We'll be right back after this word from our fine sponsors over at St. Jude. Actually, I'm just making that up. St. Jude aren't sponsoring this video. However, my good friend Mike Hurley, my co-host of the Test Drivers podcast, is doing an amazing podcast-a-thon to support the St. Jude Children's Hospital. Now, this is a cause that I seriously love and support. St. Jude does a lot of amazing work. And for this next month, they're raising as much money as they can to help support St. Jude. So I, of course, will be donating myself. And if you would like to help support not only Mike and the whole Relay crew for their giant podcast-a-thon, but you also can help support St. Jude by checking out the link in the description. So this is a vehicle that happens to have a web browser in the center display. So what I have done is I have tethered this particular vehicle to my Z Flip, so we are on 5G, and I've loaded up Windows 365. Now I've not pressed the open in browser button yet, so let's just see what happens. Oh no, this client isn't officially supported on your browser device, but it said you can use it anyway. Ooh. Cause I don't even know what kind of browser this is. It's probably some Chromium thing. The client might not work the way it's designed to. Oh yes, yes, activate all the things, yes. All my resources, jailbreak my car. Go for it. It can't open the remote port. It's not doing it.
Okay.
All right, I think that's a fail. I think we found the first device that does not support Windows 10, which is a whole vehicle.
Well.
Oh yeah.
So, this is the Scion IQ from the building a PC in a car video, except the PC isn't here anymore. Instead, we have an Xbox Series X. We have an insider version of Microsoft Edge, which should in theory let us run Windows 365. We are finally doing the thing that Microsoft should have done in the first place.
Windows on an Xbox.
Windows on an Xbox. This is something that we've wanted, all of us here in the office, for a long time. We're never gonna get it, but this is gonna be the next best thing, right?
Oh my God, it's working.
Wait, ooh, Windows. Right. So this in theory should work. We haven't tried this wireless keyboard mouse at all.
Works.
Wow.
Flawless. Okay. Wait, go full screen on it. Oh my God, it's... We did it! Yo!
Dude, this is great. Wait, actually open up a video or something.
Wait, oh, the Cyan video! Cyan video!
That is a little too on the nose. We're not logged into YouTube, by the way.
Just happened to be served the video of us building the car.
We are quite literally.
Oh, that's literally in
the
here.
Fastest gaming PC.
This is a win. This is absolutely 100% a win.
Yeah. I mean, shout out to Xbox for putting Microsoft Edge, full Microsoft Edge on there with Chromium.
Yeah.
So, makes a lot of things possible, including this. Though, I guess my question is, can we do xCloud?
No, you can't do xCloud.
Are you going to?
Okay, so hang on. So let me just be clear. Right now, we're gonna run xCloud via the Windows system in the cloud. So basically, we're double clouding over 5G into an Xbox in the back of a car.
Yes.
We're clouding on cloud. Oh, did you get it?
No. Yo. Oh my God. I
Yo.
Hate it. Oh.
Wait.
That is awful.
I mean, that is about 4 frames per second. Wait, we're updating Destiny. No wonder it's running back.
Oh yeah, let's turn that off. Wow, we have good 5G here, damn.
Look at that! Oh, okay, so our performance was just down to the fact that we were downloading Destiny over 5G. If only we could actually just play Xbox games on an Xbox. I like how we're going through all this trouble when we have an Xbox we could just play games on.
Well, this is not the intended use case.
No,
so...
I don't think any of this is an intended use case. I don't think they ever imagined that someone would be this stupid to be able to go this far to push technology beyond its outer limits to explore new horizons, to experience the wonder of poor decision making. Thank you very much for watching. Please be sure to subscribe to the channel for other hijinks and shenanigans like this. And until next time, we're going to go 6 layers deep in the cloud until we can't find a way out.